Why, here is a MOSFET at DC input line. This is a circuit for FTTH router. This is input jack. After input jack, here is a power MOSFET 4431C. In this router, no MOSFET. Let's see this circuit configuration. Input terminal. After input terminal, two lines are entering in the circuit. This line and this line. This is negative side. Negative side is reaching to this dual line filter 501, 500 microhenry and two filter capacitors. It is EMI filter circuit. EMI protection. Why EMI protection is used in this circuit? Because there are too many switching regulators that are switching at 300 kHz, 500 kHz, 1 MHz like that. To protect the DC line, this EMI circuit will block all the noises. Ground line, return path, after passing this MOSFET, it is common ground to the circuit. But positive line, from here, entering here at source pin, it is P-channel MOSFET, SI4431C. There is a capacitor, two resistors, then this switch. When this MOSFET will turn on, it will pass these voltage to the output line. Here are decoupling capacitors and polar capacitors. This switch will pass just only ground path. When it will turn on, it will pass ground path to this resistor network. Let's draw the circuit. Positive DC line, 12 volts. And this is return path. Then reaching to MLC capacitors. And then these voltages are reaching to this inductor. 500 microhenry. Then other capacitor bank. Then these voltages are passing to this MOSFET. It is P-channel MOSFET. Very low RDS on. It is 9 ampere, 30 volt power MOSFET. Here are two resistors. One is connected to source pin. Source is positive because it is P-channel MOSFET. Then it is reaching to this gate. 100 kilo-ohm, 10 kilo-ohm, 100k, 10k. And there is another capacitor. This capacitor network will protect this circuit from bouncing of the switch. These switches make bouncing. That may cause sparking. To protect the next circuit from bouncing of this switch, this power switch is used. It is DC line switch. When this switch is off, voltage will reach to source pin, but it will not allow to reach to the load. When switch is closed, this ground path will be provided to the gateway because it is P-channel. For its working condition, gate must be connected to low side. When it is connected to low side, it will allow to flow the current. Its internal resistance, RDSR, around 0.032 ohm, approximately 32 milli ohm. That is very low resistance. So it is 9 ampere, 30 volt. DC voltage positive and this side is negative. Negative will reach here and positive will pass to this side. And these positive voltage are reaching to this point. This time voltage are not passing to output side. Voltage are present here, but these are not passing to this side because this switch is off now. switch is off, gate is at 12 volt positive. Now I will press this switch, turn on. Now gate is dropped to 1 volt. And we have output here, 11.98. 11.9 in, 11.9 out. Just only 7 millivolt are dropped across this channel. Now switch is off. When switch is on, it will pass the voltage. Let's suppose this MOSFET is damaged. It is not turning on. What we can do? We have option, just only remove it and make a jumper from source to drain pin. That time this switch will be bypassed automatically. That time when plug is connected, power will reach directly to the next circuit. That time this switch will be bypassed. If you want to find some equivalent, that time we will find low RDS on. Its RDS is just only 0.032 ohm. If you see this router, positive, negative. These voltages are reaching to this switch. And when switch is on, positive and negative will be switched to the load. But to protect the processor, to protect the all sensitive electronics, this is the best option to use MOSFET based DC line switch. If this video is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.